Hello everyone and welcome back to the walkthrough. I'm going to try to get up to Grunty's lair in a more efficient manner. Like, so I don't use as many eggs so I can conserve them for the fight. So let's try a different method here. Well, I shouldn't say try. I've already found the best method that I could, or at least I think. So switch to ice eggs. Go about to here. Fire diagonally. There we go. That's how it's done. And Talon Trot over here. Grab these eggs just to refill. And there you go. So, the final boss is beyond this panel. Well, pad. Let's start! It's Grunty's lair, of course. It's not completely built, but she already seems to have some sort of audience. Let's see if she'll be able to defeat me. Nah, probably not. I practiced this fight a bunch of times, actually. Although, it is a rather tough fight. It is an endurance match, basically. I mean, you'll be able to tell what to do on these first couple phases here, because you've done this before. And, if you're wondering why I don't use the, Rattatat Wrap on bosses, it's because it doesn't do any more damage on bosses than it does, than it would on enemies. Like, it does more damage to enemies, but it doesn't do more damage to bosses, so I just keep it nice and simple by just doing the roll attack. Anyway, so she's shooting now, and now she's gonna drop down, no biggie. You know how to dodge these shots, it's just like facing off against Klungle's potions. This is probably the easiest portion of this, because it's quite predictable overall. Although, maybe the next phase is a little bit easier because of the fact that she's up in the air and she's shooting these blasts down to the ground. You can see where she is and you just have to avoid her line wherever she's moving, basically. Here, it's like this. See, she's moving down, she's moving up, she's moving down again. So you just stay away from her line and it's very, very easy to dodge your shots. Basically move whenever you have to move, basically, not just to move, you know, basically. And one more time, and no, of course the boss isn't going to be over that quickly. Come on, I told you this is an endurance match. And there we go, phase one is done. But remember that I said that you should pay attention to the character names and stuff like that? I hope you memorize the music, the areas, the mini-games, pretty much everything, because, listen, we are going to be quizzed on everything! It's game show time! Alright, I gotta be quiet whenever they say like a game sound or song, just so I can hear it over my own voice. So yeah, she's not gonna let you go up unless you beat her in this quiz game. You have to get more right than wrong in order to progress, obviously. Briegel Beach! Yeah! You can tell, oh god, minigame time! You can tell how many you beat on the bottom of the screen there. Oh god, I gotta get all the eggs, and I've only got one shot at this! Well, aside from, you know, having to restart the quiz. Oh god. Please get all the eggs, Banjo. You can do it. Well, I can do it. Yeah! Slide mastery, baby! And that's it. Because I got 2 out of 3 right. Sounds good to me. And you get popped up here to the next floor. And it's a rematch versus Klungo! This one's a lot easier than the one in the, ice arena, because, you know, you're not slipping around. Although you're gonna have to deal with some, oh shoot, why would I do that? Although you're gonna have to deal with some, spookos. Oh, these, yeah. Green ones, use, oh, poopers! That's not good. Use red eggs versus the green ones. I am not doing well. That's not good. Because as I said, this is an endurance match. I've already lost some health there. Oh god. Kill him. Oh god, please stay away. I would appreciate it if you were to. And it's kind of hard to whip out Kazooie when you're being attacked by them, because by the time you whip her out, they're already on you. So that's kind of the trick of those spookos there, is that you gotta stay away from them until they stop pursuing you, and then whip out Kazooie, switch the eggs that you need. That's pretty much it. Oh yeah! I guess I'm not doing too badly. Yeah, sure, she's calling. Sure, everyone's gonna believe that. Quiz part two! This one's a lot longer, though. Obviously, the Grunty Industries. Breagle Beach. Breagle. Breagle Peak? Yeah. Oh god, minigame. Skill time! Oh, it's another slide. Oh, I gotta race him down, okay. This was probably the easiest version out of all of them, actually. Woo! Just avoid the oil slicks, which is actually most likely tar. But how does tar even work on water, if that's the case? I mean, I would think, you know, oil floats on water, so that's why I think it's oil. And, well, I don't know how tar would be sticky on water either, because it would just kind of, like, stick to you, but not necessarily slow you down if you get a little bit on you, because, you know, it's just... because you're swimming and it's not like you're stuck to something. I think you get what I'm saying here, and I probably should stop right there, because, you know, the whole game logic thing. Hey, I won! Woo! Mumbo's Pad! One more. It sounded like gold feathers. Yeah! And apparently it builds her power, and this is the final phase at Winky Bunion Tower! That's apparently her last name. So, get ready to see her life bar, and she's gonna have a bunch of new attacks here that you're gonna have to look out for as well, so this is by far the toughest fight in the game, especially since you have to endure the rest of the stuff before you even get here. So, it's gonna be a repeat of the first part, of her just charging at you with the shield, no big deal, but she pops out of her suit this time, her spirit, her ghost, whatever you want to call it, and then you gotta roll at the spirit after hitting the shell, so to speak. Yeah, and you can't do it twice. I've tried it before, it doesn't work. I'll show you again. Oh no, she's jumping, this isn't good. Do little circles, you should be able to dodge her pretty well. One, two, see, it fails, you can't do more than one. Oh god, little circles, okay. The reason why I recommend little circles when you move around is because she moves rather haphazardly, and oh god, now she's shooting. And when she's moving like that, she can't really turn tightly, and that's the easiest way to dodge her. And oh god. It's a good way to lead her, I mean, it's a good thing to lead her to the edge of the arena, because you don't have to worry about not being able to hit her spirit in time, because the further you are away from the wall, like, the spirit always moves away from wherever it is to the opposite wall, so that's why you always want to fight her, I mean, hit her when she's off to the edge of the screen, if at all possible. Like this, you can't really control the outcome out of, you just gotta hope that she's in a good position. Sometimes you might not be able to hit her spirit, other times you will, but it's still just a matter of endurance, just watching her pattern, just dodging her stuff. No big deal. Oh god. And there we go. Now here comes the new attack. She's gonna start shooting homing blasts at you. And these suckers are incredibly annoying. Do little circles around them as well. And you also gotta dodge Grunty along with it too. So it can often corner you if you're not careful with that. One more, oh god, homing, oh, just watch them together, and, oh god, there we go, and then her suit blows up, you don't have to hit her spirit again, well, you do after this point, but now, she's gonna split into multiple Grunty spirits, and you gotta figure out which is the real one. The real one is always the faster moving one, the one that moves differently than the other ones, basically. Just watch them. It's this one. Okay, one more hit. Am I gonna be able to beat this without taking any hits? Wow, I did! Well, I mean, the last part of this, I took hits on the other one, but... Woo! And the game is beat! Seriously, that's it. Well, it's a lot harder if you don't know what you're doing, but since I did, I had a rather easy time. I also practiced this boss a bunch of times, because I had to prepare stuff ahead of time as well. You'll see what I mean after the credits. Well, that did not go well for Grunty. But did you expect otherwise? Team Rocket's blasting off again! I was a little late there. That sounds good to me. Phew! And Grunty goes back under the rock. Guess her spirit had to return to her body in order to survive or something, I don't know. But as you can see, there's still Mecha Grundy at the bottom left corner there as the head, so I don't get that. And where's Klungo? There he is. And he's probably going to try to keep shifting that rock again. And this leads up to the events of Banjo-Kazooie, basically. That's how they splice this game in here. Like, because she started out under a rock and she ended under the rock. So that's how they are able to put it in between Banjo-Kazooie and Banjo-Kazooie in the timeline. Woo! Why, thank you. That is true. At least for the 100% portion. And one more disco time. Woo! Okay, no disco that time, because I wasn't being transformed, I'm being transported. And all is well. Sweet! You're welcome. My pleasure. Because this game was fun. Until you get to the next Grunty Industries. Oh, sorry, I'm just a little off track. Uh-oh. Oh, you player mumbo. How do you shuffle with wings? It's kind of... I think that would be kind of difficult. And... Oh, don't worry, they're fine. He just wanted to learn how to dance. Or does he? Woo! Okay, they end up being one more disco time. And your rank is determined by how much stuff you collected. Since I got all... everything, I got five... wait a second? Four Jiggies? Where... why did I... I'm missing one Jiggy. Maybe because I don't have all the gold coins? Maybe? Well, anyway, this is the credits, and this is where you get the gold coins from. Remember that arcade machine back... at Spiller's Harbor? Yeah, this is where you get them from way, 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 way later on in the game during the credits. Oh, geez. Try to avoid the obstacles, otherwise you won't be able to collect as many coins along the way, because you gotta keep up your speed in order to collect coins. You're aiming for 160 of them, and yeah, that's pretty much all there is to it, but you can't get all 160 on this first run. There's just not enough time, not enough coins to do it, but you can aim for over 80 each run you go through the credits here. So yeah, you're gonna have to beat Grunty again in order to get all the coins you need. Don't worry, I set this up ahead of time so that I already got 160 coins on another save file. So don't worry about that. I'll show you that later on, like what that arcade machine is, because I'll have everything unlocked via the coins, basically. So I didn't make the game. These awesome people did. I just made the walkthrough on it to help as well as entertain you. I always say that. And I will continue to collect coins while I avoid the obstacles of doom. Hopefully I'll be able to make 80 coins. I think my best is like 87 or something like that. I don't really remember. It's rather short, and as I said, you can't collect all 160 in one run, so just aim for 80. And you also notice that there's repeating obstacles, so you'll be able to predict them a little bit better as you go along, you know, as you learn them a little bit more. Oh, I took the wrong path. Like, I knew I was supposed to go left there, but I went right anyway out of instinct, and I failed terribly. Oh, shoot. I'm just gonna go through the oil there to get more coins out of it. Or tower, or whatever the heck that is. Zigzag through the doom. Okay, I got 80. 85. Oh, come on, get more. Well, I'm gonna beat my record, I guess. Why, thank you! Yeah, I think that last jiggy is, you know, on the results screen, is based on how many coins you have. So, yeah. Like, you have to get all the coins in order to unlock the stuff, and then you get that last jiggy. Alright, now, back to the title screen. I can't skip this, can I? that's fine, I guess. Oh, there we go. And continue. This is the save file I have it set up on, by the way. The other 100% save file. It only took me 3 hours and 30 minutes to 100% the game in that walkthrough. Not too shabby. Alright. Back to Spiller's Harbor. Yeah, I already set up where I need to go. Because, otherwise I'd have to walk through Spiral Mountain in order to get back here. So I just, before I started this part, I saved the game at Spiller's Harbor so that I would start here immediately. So here we are at Spiller Stun, and you... Great. You probably can guess by now what this arcade machine is like. Yep, it is the mini-games we have played already. See, I got all 160 coins there. I should say, you max out at 160 coins. You can get more than 160 coins, but once you hit 160, it's done. So, yeah. You can play any of the mini-games that you've played before here, if you would like. And that's pretty much it for the walkthrough, aside from the bad ending, of which I'm going to show you now. I decided to just cut over to the new stuff here in the ending. It basically starts out just like the other part of the ending until you get back over here to Mumble's pad. And so he's going to say about the same thing until this. I think this is the spot, actually. So just wait for it. Then okay, here we go. He's unsure if the spell was correct. So let's see how this turns out. Whoa! I'm getting dizzy. And eventually it'll bring you back over to Banjo's house. And there's no Jinjos this time. Uh-oh. Well, that's not good. Oh, Mumbo. Sometimes you're unreliable, I swear. And I really don't understand this screen, the rank screen here. I looked up information on that, and I couldn't find anything. I couldn't find, like, what the requirements were to get 5 jiggies on the rank screen there. So, I mean, I even looked on my other file, which I got 160 of these gold coins, and what happened was I got the same rank. So, what I'm assuming, because there's only 2 things I haven't tried, is it's either you have to beat all the mini-games on that arcade machine again, or you have to beat the game within a certain amount of time, like a speedrun of sorts. That's the only lead that I have as to how to get that third Jiggy, so I don't know! I'm sorry. If I figure it out later, I'll update this with an annotation, but as of right now, that's all for the walkthrough, I suppose. I hope you enjoyed, and I will see you in the next walkthrough.